For many of us, the most inspirational moments of this time of year do not come from the rabbi's sermons, but actually come from the tunes, the songs that we associate with the service. But I find that the most catchy of all the high holiday tunes is one that is not at all inspirational. And it is a tune that I was taught as a young child and have probably heard every single year since. Dip the apple in the honey, make a blessing loud and clear. L'shana tova u'metuka, have a happy, sweet new year. And while this tune may not be particularly inspirational, when I saw an idea on this week's Torah portion that relates to the sweetness of honey, I felt that I had to share it with you this week. We are told at the end of Parshas Nitzavim that cleaving to God and loving Him is described kihu chayacha v'orech yamecha. It is our lives and the length of our days. But it seems redundant. What does it mean that devoting ourselves to God is chayacha v'orech yamecha? It is both our lives and the length of our days. Doesn't that mean the exact same thing? Rabbi Simcha Bunim of Pishischa, one of the great Polish Hasidic rabbis, explains, using a metaphor, that there are two types of sweetness in life. And he uses our metaphor of the honey. There are things in life that are sweet, that taste good, but are not particularly good for us. Cake, cookies, candy. He uses the example of the natural honey. Honey may taste good, but it's not good for us. On the other hand, there are things in life that are good for us, and it's in our long-term best interest to consume them, but they really don't taste so good. And he uses the example of a bitter medicine. The medicine doesn't taste good, but you know that it's important. You know that it's something that you need to consume and something that's in your long-term best interest. Kihu chayecha v'orech yamecha. Living a life devoted to God is in our long-term best interest, but it is also sweet in the moment as well. Devoting ourselves to a life of Torah and mitzvos is sweet right now and also sweet in the long run. I wish you all a good Shabbos and a Shana Tova u'metuka, one where the sweetness of living a life of Torah can be part of a happy, healthy, sweet new year.